Yeah, welcome back to EEP 15. Today I would only like to give you a very brief progress overview. We're looking down on our freight traffic layout, which gets a little bit busier. And there were various areas that I have worked on and I wanted to show them to you and give you an update. So in the last episode, we looked at this region in detail, which is the sawmill in the Lausa station, where we had our lumber shunting forward and backwards. And there are various other areas that I have worked in the meanwhile. So let me go into the 3D view. And let's go first to the smaller changes and then work our way up. So there used to be always a tunnel here, but it was half open. I closed it again because I didn't like the look of it. I'd experimented around with it, but it didn't look right. So I made it a regular tunnel, which connects up here to the top station, which is still floating in the air. So I have to, that is certainly one of the last areas I have to do. Here is a tunnel where you can actually leave and it connects to a completely different area of the map in order to have a complete closed loop so that you can actually take a car and drive over the layout, which is probably fun to do. In any case, this road now is completely connected. It goes into a tunnel also on the other side here and emerges here. Built here this supporting wall and connected finally this lonely houses here. Now we see that the narrow gauge railroad just passing through. I finally connected this two lonely outbuildings here, or built here a new bridge, go through some empty area, but it's now connecting the abbey as well. We made just some minor changes to the cemetery. That is all I did here. There's a little construction zone. We pass underneath the branch line and going here into Hartsgerode village from the top. And here I have added a little bit something as well. Beside the road, I've added a little bit in an industrial commercial area near the train station, gas fuel station. I added these two buildings on the other side of the crossing. I worked a little bit here on the main village square and kind of almost finished the church with a surrounding wall and some people and the churchyard and things like that. So I'm happy with that. Then the road connects out of Hartsgerode into the open countryside that is completely unfinished and emerges here on the other side of the river close to our harbor that is here in the background. And new is the power plant and this bridge. So the power plant gets brown coal delivered either by barge or by railway, which is unloaded into this large bins here. One question I would like to discuss later with you is how to connect this to the rest of the layout. The whole power plant is designed so that when you have the river side defined on one side, it's actually better to have the rail just thematically coming from this side than from this side. Otherwise, it would make more sense to just, you know, change the layout of the rail here and just have it connect this way. But if I turn everything around, it looks kind of awkward. I have to put the buildings in areas that they were not intended, kind of. It looks not quite as nice. So I've decided to make the rail connection from this side because of the river and the road, though. It's not easy to turn around here, though I'm kind of forced to go over the river and then we can later decide what to do next. Anyhow, the road continues. Let's just finish the road. Connects finally here to the little Scharfenstein dead end and up here to the soda factory, back into town. I've changed the roads and the buildings here. These buildings of a different style and new I put a road back here. I put some buildings here just as a facade later to catch the eye when you look from down here. There will be a little soccer stadium. There's a little bit, not an industrial area, like a commercial district here. And the major new thing here is the tram depot. There will be a little tram line coming out of the depot here, servicing the city, but not only the city. It will also connect the harbor, though it goes underneath the main train station, comes out here, connects the harbor, follows the river, and connects to, you know, a regional, it's like an S train or a regional, very regional train, connects here to off the map cities here and back here as well. So it goes behind the lake region. Here I probably will install a, oh, there are some roads already driving around. Look at that. Anyways, oh, here you have to take the pedestrian walkway away. That doesn't look right. Here we'll put a marketplace in and kind of stalls, temporary market, like a weekly market, where people have their colorful awnings and their tents, and they'll have here their weekly market in this region. And then I have added, let me just go there in one swoop. Here, the swampy region, I have added this wooden rail, which is actually intended for a smaller track. There's kind of, I call it a guide rail in the middle, which is actually the 600 millimeter rail for which this is intended. I don't think we can take it away. You can only add a larger one. Maybe it's a relic, but even for the 1000 millimeter train, it doesn't look, you know, completely wrong sized. I think it's okay. So I tried to make this overgrown with, you know, this almost hidden waterways between the different lakes, and I hope that that looks realistic. So let me see, did I forget something? We did the roads. Oh, the tram, yes, we talked about the tram and the tram depot. The changes in the city itself. And then, of course, the coal power plant. And that is actually the issue I would like to discuss today. What to do? I basically, I wouldn't say forced, but I'm kind of bound to go over this river. There's no way to realistically lay the track kind of here in a very narrow curve around here. That doesn't make any sense. So I'm here. Now I can connect to the branch line somehow and then have trains run from the harbor all the way around here and into the coal power plant to deliver coal. Alternatively, I could just make it a completely separate track, run it here off the layout, kind of pretend it connects here somehow as a third track, and have coal come from off the map. And the third alternative will be is to still run it out of here, but via a virtual connection, have it kind of turn around here and have a coal mine here. We would put the road maybe a little bit further west, have here a ridge line that connects optically this village that I don't want to have directly near a coal mine, and perhaps a mine that is here kind of on the other side of the ridge at the very edge of the map. And we have here almost like a little diorama looking from the east here on the coal mine. Third alternative, no, that was the third. The fourth alternative would be to have a coal mine after connecting to the regional line, which is this one here, have a coal mine here in the center, That is a big empty area, completely unallocated. And I have to work here on the river, obviously. I was thinking about that this area is possible, but it is not really nice here. It doesn't make sense to have a coal mine in this area. I mean, it could be an open ground mine, but certainly not a mine in mountain. I could put it back here into these mountains, but that is an area where this little cute tourist train goes through. I don't want to really have a coal mine back there. So that are the four options: off the track, having it behind Harzgerode, having it in the center, or just connect to the regional line and getting stuff from the harbor, which is kind of ridiculous because the harbor is right beside the coal plant and it would make a huge loop to drive in from here. If you have a great idea how to solve this amongst those four options, or maybe you come up with something better even, let me know. Otherwise, in the next episode on this layout, we'll look at some coal traffic, where our coal train will arrive. Currently, that's all static here. Nothing is happening here yet. And the coal traffic will arrive and will be unloaded by the cranes, and the locomotive sets over and then leaves again to the mining area. And maybe I built even the mining area already, if I build a mine. Anyhow, that was it for today. That were all the updates. I'm really enjoying this layout. It's slowly getting somewhere. It's a big hodgepodge, a little bit of everything. It's a big test bed for me. It is not a well-designed, clear-themed layout at all, but it's kind of everything goes, and I build along just wildly. So that it's probably not the ideal way of building things, but I enjoy it nonetheless. Thanks for watching. See you next time around, and have a wonderful evening. Bye-bye.